So the program is sort of the biggest nuclear weapons extension program, if you will, in terms of how much you fiddle with the weapon that they have undertaken so far. This is a weapon where we take an existing warhead and we life extend it. We brush it off. We replace components in it that are maybe too old, expired. Maybe we just had to build entirely new components. But the core assembly, so to speak, is not significantly changed. The new thing about this particular weapon is that they are building a tail kit, that is a guided tail kit, that uses an inertial guidance system to steer the weapon toward its target more precisely than existing B-61 bombs can do.
So, two questions there. One is, if they're not building a whole new bomb, they're just replacing the some of the key components.
Yes.
Really, when you're done, do you end up with a new weapon, or is it really just a refurbished old weapon?
You don't end up with a new warhead, but a weapon is more than just a warhead. It is a full system that can fly toward its target and work the way it's supposed to do. The new in this one is the tail kit. And there have been plans back in the early 1990s. The Air Force wanted to have sort of a precision, low-yield guided nuclear bomb at that time, but that was defeated by Congress. And one of the reasons was that they were concerned about a so-called slippery slope of nuclear targeting, where we begin to build weapons that appear more usable.
So if you make a nuclear weapon more usable, in that it can be used in more different scenarios, don't you increase the chances that nuclear weapons will be used?
Well, the decision to use a nuclear weapons is a political decision that has to be made by the president. And that will never be an easy decision, with a guided tail kit or without one. But I think for the military planners, there is a temptation to try to use modernization of nuclear weapons to make them more flexible and give more option to the war planners. And one of the real key options they're trying to, I think, achieve with this weapon is they want to be able to hold at risk targets and if necessary, try to destroy them with less radioactive fallout.
So, is it a good idea? Do you have an opinion on whether this is a smart use of taxpayer dollars, whether it makes sense from a national security perspective? Do they need to do this?
Well, as long as you want to have nuclear weapons in your stockpile, you have to make decisions about extending them, for sure. The question is, how much do you need to improve them when you do that? In my view, the tail kit is a step too far. It's more likely that a military commander will go to the president with this weapon and say, Mr. President, all other options are out of the question, but we have a good one here that doesn't pollute a whole lot. You know, this is an attractive weapon purely in terms of collateral damage. And the question is, should we be making nuclear weapons that are more usable, that have less collateral damage? After all, the point of these things is to deter potential use of nuclear weapons against us and our allies.
So let me ask you, should we?
Yeah, we are.
Well, I know we are, but you pose the question, should we be doing it?
We should be doing it as long as we have nuclear weapons. You should maintain your nuclear weapons. But in my view, you don't need to enhance the capabilities of the weapons, and that's what we're doing in this case.